This is The Coalition.
We created this show to start a discussion
about topics that are unique to this day and age.
Online activism, what does it do? It raises awareness for social issues. And if you've ever shared a video about a cause, worn an awareness bracelet, donated through text message, signed an online petition, or purchased a product because they donate to charity, then you've aided in raising awareness.
But by definition, that makes you a slacktivist. Slacktivists, anyone who does something in support of an issue or cause that requires minimal personal effort.
Now, whether you use the term negatively or positively, there's no denying that slacktivists can raise awareness for an issue overnight in ways no one could ever do before.
And yes, awareness is great, but can social media campaigns compare to the sort of high-risk activism that took place during the civil rights and anti-war movements of the 50s and 60s?
Back in the days, it was coming from the civil rights movement. It was coming from the war movement. So there was a lot more interaction with the actual politics because it meant people's livelihood like it does in third world countries. In a first world country, you can literally not pay attention for a second of your life to politics and you're gonna have a perfect life, a beautiful life. So there's no reason for the young generation to go outside and protest, say something, you know, what you believe, because you have a perfect life.
When my parents were probably like 10 or in their early teens, I mean, there was marches going on and people being hosed down and beat up, you know, and slammed left and right. I don't want to do that, you know. I don't want to go out there and get beat up, you know, or get arrested just for standing out marching. So it's created this somewhat reserved, you know, posture because I just find that we're a bit comfortable, you know?
And that's exactly how critics like Malcolm Gladwell feel, stating that online activism is ineffective because doing good from the comfort of your computer screen lessens real-life political participation.
You kind of feel like you're doing something by promoting it, and I think that you are because you're creating awareness, but I think that then we feel like we're allowing ourselves to let other people do something about it. I can't go to Africa and help these people. I can't, you know, quit my job and grab a rifle and hunt this man down. Like, it's really just, maybe they'll take care of it if I let them know about it.
There's no denying that this is a tricky subject. And although we may be comfortable, living in a digital world doesn't mean you can't do good.
And that's why discussion is key in shaping what the future of online activism will be.
There's a desire within us, all of us somewhere, to feel strongly about something, but there's so much going on in this world that the next event that happens, whether it's Coney or whatever, you forget that last one.
It's in style to be socially conscious, but I don't think that's a bad thing. It should always be cool to do well. And the longer it is cool, I think we should take advantage of that.
I think no effort is too large or too small. So you clicked on something, you shared it on Twitter and Facebook, but you don't know who's gonna take what you did, click, but then go further with it. Or then be so inspired that they're like, I can't believe this is happening, I wanna do more.
In the discussion of trying to remain optimistic about what we are calling slacktivism, there can be positive social outcomes from everything we do. And to understand or pretend like the society we live in is only negative is doing it a disservice. So let's start looking at what good can come out of it. I mean, we're gonna be fine.
So what does online activism achieve? Join the discussion in the comments section below.